We want them back home. But we want them back home for the right reasons, not for the wrong reasons. You cannot appease a leadership like there is in Iran. If you appease them once, you have to appease them twice. And if you appease them twice, you have to appease them three times. You cannot appease a terrorist regime. Make this decision on the merits of the case, on no other factor. And let's take a look. You know, I was a prosecutor. I was a district attorney. Mr. Sotis didn't read my whole background. I was mayor for 8 years, district attorney for 8 years in Philadelphia, and then governor. And, of course, Mayor Giuliani was one of the most famous prosecutors in the history of the United States of America. And we can tell you that the merits of this case, when you look at the case, it's overwhelming for the MEK to be delisted. There are several types of evidence in the American justice system. The first is expert witnesses. Expert witnesses are people who have special reason to give an opinion about something. And they're qualified as experts to give that opinion. Well, let me just go over a quick list, and you're going to hear from some of them today, of the experts who have firsthand knowledge of the MEK, firsthand knowledge of Camp Ashraf, firsthand knowledge of what went on in Iran and Iraq, who have testified and said loud and clear publicly that the MEK should be delisted. Let's start with Louis Freeh, the head of the FBI. The head of the FBI in the Clinton administration and the Bush administration. Director Freeh was tasked with having the FBI look at all of the residents of Camp Ashraf and determine whether they were terrorists. He found none. The FBI found none. The director will talk about that. Judge Mukasey, a wonderful Circuit Court of Appeals judge who later became Attorney General, one of his basic tasks was to root out terrorism. He got reports on a daily basis, and he's spoken out before and will speak out again today, that the MEK is not a terrorist organization. Three United States generals, one of which we have with us today, General Conway, the Commandant of the Marine Corps, who were stationed in Iraq, have testified clearly that the MEK is not a terrorist organization. Colonel Wesley Martin, who couldn't be with us today, but who was the commandant, the American commandant, at Iraq during the time that we had the responsibility for protecting it, who got to know a lot of those residents personally, has said that it's laughable to consider them terrorists, or the MEK a terrorist organization. The European Union, the United Kingdom, countries who once listed the MEK as a terrorist organization, have taken affirmative steps to delist. Members, high-ranking members of the CIA, the NSA, that's the National Security Administration, DHS, that's the Department of Homeland Security, and the State Department. We have Ambassador Reese with us today. They all have come out and said the MEK is not a terrorist organization. And the Court of Appeals itself directed Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice to re-review it because the Court of Appeals said that the finding that the MEK was a terrorist organization in 2009, and I'm quoting from the court's opinion, did not meet the standard for listing as a terrorist organization. So, the expert testimony is overwhelming.